Let's see now what is the relation between EMF of electrochemical cell and Gibbs energy of the reaction. See, what is this Gibbs energy? I will tell an example. In the morning we are fresh, we will have some energy, enthusiasm, and we will work. Up to what? Up to we get tired up to evening. From morning to evening, see, in the morning we have energy, we have done work. In the evening we lose every energy and we have tired. So that energy, because of that energy only we have done work, that is maximum work, and the energy is decreased from morning to evening. So that is decrease in energy or change in energy. That is only this gives energy for reaction. See, if for Daniell cell, electrons will be flowing from anode to cathode, you know that because of that only current will be there in opposite direction and bulb is glowing. Now electrons moving from anode to cathode on its own means there is some energy. Because of that energy only electrons are moving. So that energy is called Gibbs energy. And because of that energy what we obtain the work is called maximum work. So this Gibbs energy of the reaction is given by delta G, that is change in Gibbs energy, change in energy, that equal to minus NF into E cell. See, this is the relation between delta G and E cell. E cell is EMF of cell. See, what are the terms in this equation? Delta G is Gibbs energy, and N is the number of moles of electrons per mole product. F is Faraday constant, you know that 96487 coulomb per mole. E cell is EMF of the cell. See, if this in E cell, if the concentration of this electrolytic solution is unity, then E cell will be called as the standard E cell. See, then what will become? This E cell become E naught cell, that is standard EMF of the cell. Then this will be the relation when the concentration of this electrolytic solution is unity. Let's see now what is this relation between equilibrium constant and Gibbs energy. See, Gibbs free energy and equilibrium constant relation, you know this. Delta G naught equal to minus RT ln K, that is logarithm of K means equilibrium constant. You know this relation. This is a standard change in energy, and this is a gas constant, this is temperature, this is equilibrium constant, and this is logarithm of base E. In this, just now you come to know that delta G naught is minus NF E naught of cell. So minus NF E naught of cell equal to minus RT ln K. This minus and this minus will get cancelled. What is left? NF E naught of cell equal to RT ln K. Remember this equation. See, relation between equilibrium constant and E naught of cell. This is very useful in solving the problem. I will solve some problem by using this equation and delta G naught equal to minus NF E naught cell. By using those two equations, I will solve some problem in the next videos. Thank you. Subscribe to my channel to get more videos. Like the video, share the video, and spread worldwide to help others.